Now get that Friday feeling by starting the day with a big breakfast.
So, have you got anything special lined up for this weekend?
I sure have, Denise. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to spend the whole weekend watching women's Olympic beach volleyball.
Yes, Johnny, the competition's almost over.
Oh, well, it's all right, Denise. Look, I'll just pace myself with this slot.
Oh, Vaughan. I said, do I look like Brigitte Bardot today?
No, you look like Caroline from Big Brother. Okay.
Thanks, Johnny. Okay, son of Ross Abbott.
Okay. Actually, who did you say I looked like the other day? You had another one.
Who's the other one?
Who was it?
No, you had a funny wig on.
It wasn't Edwina Curry. It was, I had a wig on. You said I looked like from Irene.
Irene.
From EastEnders.
You really did. If we could find that wig.
If we could find that wig,
great.
It is quite
Thank
Irene.
You,
anyway, hello,
anyway.
Welcome to Big Breakfast. It is Friday, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah.
Gorgeous ladies, make some noise. Johnny Vaughan!
Yeah! Can I just say I love all the ladies in the house this morning. I love all the ladies. I could love a million girls. And this, ladies and gentlemen, the sweetheart of the morn. She's dressed for dinner despite this early hour.
I'm going to a party.
Denise Van Outen, ladies and gentlemen! For you on this morning's show. Quite excited. I'm sure you'll agree.
At 7:10, Donna Eyre's in the house and she's going to put the girls from Sweet Female Attitude under the spotlight in the celebrity, the special celebrity final of Faster Mind.
Faster. It's Faster Mind, Lego.
Donna's got a lovely hat on today.
Whoa.
I can't see the accent.
But Sweet Female Attitude in the house this morning, that was the big thing there. Morning, Sweet Female Attitude. To say I love flowers would be a woeful understatement. It's one of the most gently, touchingly romantic records of the modern age, and we adore it. We're going to clap it now. It's a very important record. Thank you very much for coming down the house. I love all the ladies in the house this morning. At 7:20, we find that Mother Nature isn't as always nice as she seems, I'm afraid, ladies and gentlemen.
Why is that, Johnny?
All is not well in the world of vermin, Denise. We've got more news of an animal attack right here in Britain. Be afraid.
Oh,
yes,
no.
Yes, sorry to tell you. Be very, very afraid. Denise.
At 7:25, we bring you the very best film releases in this week's DVD chart.
Is there a DVD chart?
Yes.
Plus, we've got an exclusive interview with the lead singer of the truly legendary... Get ready for this, actually. This is a bit of an exclusive.
Yeah.
We've got Tom York from Radiohead. He very rarely speaks.
The York?
From
Radiohead?
From Radiohead. Are you a fan of Radiohead?
No.
Yeah.
Aren't you? No.
I find the music quite depressing.
You know, it's hard. It generally clears the floor if you whack that on in the middle of one of your house nights.
I like Tom York.
Yeah. He doesn't normally speak. He doesn't normally speak publicly. He very rarely speaks on television. So to have Tom York speaking publicly on television on the evening is quite a coup for us.
He's ready and waiting this morning. It's the lovely Jasmine Lowson.
We've got Adam and Joe as well this morning.
Oh, yeah,
Adam and Joe. It's Animation Week on the glorious Channel 4, so we got that as well.
Sorry, I just jumped in there. I'm just desperate to see Jasmine this morning.
You
Good
are.
Morning.
Because she interviewed morning. The chap from Radiohead.
She did.
Jasmine, take it away, please.
Good morning. These are the main stories on Friday, the 22nd of September. Branson's latest challenge, going car-free by choice, and Westlife tastes the good life. Camelot gets to take its case to keep its licence to the Lottery Commission later. The High Court reversed the decision to only negotiate with Richard Branson's People's Lottery. Branson reckons Camelot has no chance.
The Commission have ruled that we had the best bid, and therefore, to be quite honest, I can't quite see what Camelot feel that they have to gain by dragging the process out.
The Tories are calling for Gordon Brown to resign over the Bernie Eccleston donation, despite the Chancellor's insistence he didn't mislead the public. A new book claims Mr. Brown did know about the £1 million gift, but speaking about the allegation for the first time in a Channel 4 interview, he said he hadn't lied at all. Parts of a rocket launcher have been found near the MI6 building. Terrorists fired a small missile into the building, but no one has yet claimed responsibility. Security forces are on full alert, and political figures are being warned they must consider themselves targets. It's thought the real IRA may target the Labour conference in Brighton next week. 800 towns and cities across Europe were closing their central streets to traffic today for European Car-Free Day. 10 local areas in Britain are set to follow in the footsteps of countries such as France and Italy, but with the recent fuel crisis, many may not notice much of a difference. Camden and Covent Garden will shut off several roads, while a street party is to be held in Brixton. Westlife are poised to set a new record with an old one. Their reworking of Against All Odds with Mariah Carey is poised to take the top spot in Sunday's chart. This will be the band's sixth consecutive number one, which is a new British record. If singing cover versions was an Olympic sport, they'd all have gold medals. And here's the sport. French runner Marie-José Perec has dramatically walked out of the Olympic Games just a day before she was to defend her 400-metre title. The athlete complained of being attacked in her Sydney hotel room yesterday. Perec and her boyfriend then flew to Singapore, where they were both involved in a fracas with a cameraman. Here's the way the weather looks. Temperatures should range from 16 Celsius in Glasgow to 19 in Plymouth. Northern Ireland and East Anglia will escape the rain this morning, but the dry weather will move to the Midlands and the southwest later today. Here's the five-day forecast. More rain tomorrow in Scotland and Northern Ireland, but there'll be sunny spells until Wednesday. In northern and central regions, dry, warm weather throughout the weekend, and in the south, after a sunny spring-like weekend, the rain will be back by Tuesday. Breakfast News, it's 7:06. Now it's back to Johnny and Denise.
Yay! Hello there. Thank you very much indeed, Jasmine.
Lovely bulletins this morning.
Great set of bulletins this morning.
Yeah, great.
Any weekend plans, my love, my pet, my sweet?
I'll probably go out for a few bevvies.
Oh, hangover on Monday. Yeah.
Do you know any good parties?
You know what happened last time.
You know what happened last time. You're still feeling it on Tuesday.
Yeah.
I mean, feeling hungover.
I might go to the cinema as well. Can you recommend anything?
Cinema? Mm. Why don't you go and see Snatch?
I've seen that.
Oh, yeah.
You go and see that.
Yeah,
we go and see movie. Scary movies. Very good. Is American movie still on anywhere? I didn't see that documentary. I enjoyed that immensely, but that's a little bit highbrow, probably. Okay. Jasmine Lowson, ladies and gentlemen. She's here today on the show. Thank you very much, Jasmine. You spoke. Denise, what are you doing?
Sorry, I've just bought
the Bill Collectors at my door!
Isn't this fantastic? Look, this is what I'm going to be playing with all weekend. It's my new drum machine.
Is it?
Wow. You impressed?
That's what you call it these days. Go on then.
This machine costs just £900.
£900?
I'll tell you what, it's worth it though. You've got everything on there. You can scratch.
That doesn't sound like scratching to me, does it? You can scratch.
Look, there's all different pads.
Go on then.
Here. Shh. Hang on. So you have to press quite hard.
Basically, it's basically.
If you press hard on that bit.
Okay. Another one bites the dust. Wow, you're really playing, Denise. Let me steady it for you. I'll steady it for you, Denise. Come on, really give them a show, Denise. No, lean forward as you do it. It's much better.
Just to picture me as Phil Collins. Are you ready?
Is my knee all right? Thrust right between your legs there. Is that going to be okay? Or will that affect your bongo? Okay, here we go.
It might affect my bongos.
Okay, let's play bongo bongo. Okay,
are you ready for this?
Are you ready for some bongo bongo?
Okay, can I just have a countdown from three, please?
Three, two, one, hit it! Faster! Faster! Faster, damn you! That's just
good.
There we go, ladies and gentlemen. I think
you're
something's
like
become unplugged.
Steve Martin in the journal.
I did that, didn't I? Vaguely.
But it's a great machine. Every home should have one.
Every home should have one. I hope you've enjoyed that demonstration at home. I hope it's as much
if you're
fun
single
for you
and you're bored, then get one of these.
Yeah, indeed, my knee.
Go on, have a go.
No, I'm not going to do that, Denise. What are you up to this weekend, I've got to ask you?
Do you know what? I'm going to a party tonight.
Are you? A party? Yeah, you're dressed for it already? Yeah. That's amazing, getting ready for a party at 6 in the morning, Denise.
It's actually 7:09.
7:09.
Yeah.
But go on, Denise.
I'm going to a party. It's my friend's birthday, Sasha. She's 30.
Happy birthday, Sasha.
Happy birthday, Sasha.
Big night?
Yeah, it should be. We'll see.
But Chelsea Man United kicking off at 11:30. I think that is that live. Are you watching that? You're a Man United fan, aren't you, Sonny?
Yes, I am. Yeah.
Is that live and exclusive on Sky?
I don't watch Sky. I have no idea. So.
Well, I hope to be able to catch that. Do you know what happened
to me
yesterday?
I met Channel 4.
I met Brighty's baby yesterday.
Oh.
Mark
oh,
Bright
you?
Came round. We had a baby off at my house. I'll try and bring the photographs in on Monday. Extraordinary photographs of two proud fathers that I know would delight regular viewers of this show. Apart from that, I've got no real plans this weekend. I'm going to take it quite easy.
Yeah,
it's been
quite
a hard week, ladies and gentlemen, hasn't it?
Do you know what? The weather's so miserable. Isn't it?
Yeah, it's going to be a real.
It's so miserable.
I might
so
be semi
reclusive. Just all stay in, yeah. Keep warm.
Quite a
together.
Reclusive weekend. Off
you can all come over
home.
To mine if you want to.
We'll
all get naked and play Twister.
I'm sure your legion of stalkers watching the show will be delighted to hear their welcome.
I wonder what Donna's up to this weekend. Let's find out.
I don't know. It says
Donna,
in the script we should ask.
Doing anything special?
I'm having a shiatsu tonight.
What, you're going to eat a dog?
Are you having a shiatsu, Donna?
I am, I'm very excited. I saw rock and roll.
Is that anything to do with is the hat part of the preparation?
That's like a big
jihad. Or have you bruised your head and that's got ice in it?
Actually, I'm bald there, Johnny.
Pardon, Den?
I'm a bit bald on the right side.
Oh, you're bald on the right side, I should get one. That's a good hat, Donna. Is it Versace?
It's not Versace.
Do you think Donna looks very twiddy this morning?
If you want to get a tweed, get a hat.
She does look like, do you know, Donna is an icon. She's quite iconic, isn't she?
Mm.
Okay, let's go with Donna
you.
Now.
I like
icon.
To think so.
The icon.
I like to think so.
Okay, Donna, you can run with the ball now. You're
thank
free.
You very much. Anyway, it's going to be very busy in here this morning. Can we just all celebrate once again? It is Friday! And I made it to Friday, which is even better. But it's going to be very busy today to celebrate that because today we've got the final, the grand final of Faster Mind, everybody. Plus, we're going to be catching up with Sweet Female Attitude. They're going to be in the house. Plus, the most important thing is we want your phone calls this morning, especially if it's your birthday. Today, you share it with David from Worcester,
wow.
Haley from Essex, Michael from Barnet, and call in if you're watching this morning. We want to know what your plans are for the weekend or anything you want to talk about on this morning show. The number to do that is 0208985 or the one 0208985 or the two. Or you can, of course, email us at bigbreakfast@channel4.com. So don't forget, we'll be back with the Faster Mind final very soon. But right now, it's time to find what's going to be on TV tonight with our Japanese Ivy.
Hello, my name is Motoki from Ehime in Japan. I'm a foreigner. London like very much, but have no money left. So here's my Friday Japanese Eye View.
Must watch this to find out why Basil is a hotel manager, not a hub of BBC One.
Two dead pigeons, water tank.
What is funny?
How they get up there?
How they flew up there.
That's right.
Oink! Stop! Just pull your... Oh, not pigs, pigeons!
Our friends very fine, not like my friends at home. I'll be watch at 9 o'clock.
Hey. How are we gonna get out of that one?
What?
I can't handle two nights in a row with him.
What's wrong with Monica and Chandler?
I don't know, they're just a little blah.
Blah?
You know, he's blah. She's very loud for such a small person.
Gonna down to South Park, gonna have myself a ball tonight, 9:30, Channel 4.
I'm here live in South Park, Colorado, where citizens of Los Angeles are arriving in droves for the town's first annual film festival. This is just a small, quiet mountain community where nothing out of the ordinary ever really happens, except for the occasional complete destruction of the entire town. And so the excitement level is naturally very high.
I'm Motoki from Ehime in Japan, and that was my last Japanese Eye View. Sayonara, Johnny and Denise.
Fantastic. Right now, it is Friday, which can only mean one thing. It is time for Friday's final edition of Faster Mind, where our three daily winners will be going head-to-head for the chance to win this DVD player. Some top movies. Yes, it's time for today's edition of Faster Mind. Woo!
Mastermind.
Yes, to help us play Celebrity Faster Mind this morning, please welcome my guest this morning, Sweet Female Attitude. Lovely to see you again.
You too, Dom.
We'll be talking to you in a little while, but are you feeling confident this morning?
Yes.
Yes.
All good, all good. As usual, our chosen specialist subject will be knowledge. General knowledge. On the lines now to give us their guesses on how many correct answers Sweet Female Attitude will get, we have our daily winners. So we're going to meet line one. Good morning to Michael.
Good morning.
How are you? Nice to speak to you again, Michael.
Hi.
Yeah, how
very
you feeling?
Well this morning. The weather's terrible here, but I'm feeling fine.
Yes, but it's Friday. Are you excited for your weekend?
Oh, yeah.
What are you going to be doing, Michael?
I haven't decided yet.
All right. Well, listen, good luck this morning. How many answers do you think Sweet Female Attitude are going to get right this morning?
Four.
Four.
We're educated people!
Four. All right, thank you. Let's move over to line two. We've got Gary there. Good morning, Gary.
Good morning, Donna.
How are you this morning?
I'm okay, a bit tired.
A bit tired, tell me about it. We're all hanging by a thread, but we're hanging in there and it's good to be there. How many answers do you think Sweet Female Attitude are going to get right this morning?
I think they're going to get seven.
A bit more confidence there. Do we have John on the line? Because somebody's just telling me in my earpiece now that John will not get out of bed, apparently. I know how you feel, John, but you could make the effort. You know what I'm saying. Is John there? No. All right, it's just between Michael and Gary then. All right, if we've got our guesses there, can I have 60 seconds on the clock, please? Let's play Celebrity Faster Mind. Yeah. Liam Gallagher is the lead singer of which band?
Oasis.
Which is the capital city of Spain?
No idea.
Madrid. What is 3 multiplied by 5?
15.
What happens to Pinocchio's nose when he lies?
Grows.
It grows longer, it certainly does. Brad Pitt is married to which famous actress?
Jennifer Aniston.
What is the name of the clown in The Simpsons?
Krusty.
Krusty. Who's number one in the charts?
Mojo Lady.
It certainly is. Which Southampton artist kept your single Flowers
Craig
off the
David.
Number once? Yes. Which member of the royal family have recently turned 16?
Harry.
What is the world's longest river?
Oh.
Nile.
It is the Nile. Oh! Which famous is naked on the cover of a woman's magazine this month?
Robbie Williams.
It is Robbie Williams. Actor Max Beasley is dating which Spice
Mel
Girl?
Mel B.
It is Mel B. Hillary Clinton is aiming to be a senator for which major US city?
No idea.
New York. And who is married to Fred Flintstone?
Wilma.
Oh. On that note, well done. I have to congratulate you both because you did very well there. But our winner this morning is Gary!
Gary!
Congratulations! Gary! You're our winner! Fantastic! You've got this DVD player plus the movies. How are you feeling?
Fantastic. Woo! Excellent. Thank you very much.
I'm sure that's going to come in very handy with this weather at the moment. In fact, I might go and get one myself. Anyway, thank you very much, Gary. Thanks to our girls this morning.
Yeah.
We're going to be talking to Sweet Female Attitude a little bit later. After the break, we've got an exclusive interview with Radiohead's Tom York. But right now, this is Channel 4, the show that's got all the answers. Yeah!
What's she doing here? This isn't our school.
You don't think she's gonna be our ice skating teacher, do you?
No way. It's Saturday. Teachers can't teach on Saturdays. It's against union regulations. Unless she's a scab.
There we go. That's all part of Animation Week. Right here on the glorious Channel 4. Okay, here on The Big Breakfast, we're no strangers to the untamed world of nature. A cruel world driven by bloodlust and ruled by tooth and claw. Take this example of brute aggression we featured on this very show a few weeks ago. Have a look-see.
Well, I was in the field looking for my cat Sylvester, and I saw a big black tail, and I went up to it, and it was the biggest cat I've ever seen.
These are the marks here from is this from its teeth
whenever it,
no, these are the claw marks.
That's the claw marks over the face.
There are some of the marks there, and the rest are in the crown of his head.
A vicious panther attack there, but now worryingly there's been another outbreak of crazed animal savagery. This time it's a squirrel, ladies and gentlemen. Sorry, I'm fighting back Windy Pop's head. You noticed that? It was a bit of a struggle, but I think I've got over it now. Here to tell us about his close encounter is 9-year-old Michael Rennie and his mum Monique. Welcome to the show, ladies and gentlemen. Sorry, I have to laugh at Rennie. It's my chosen brand. I'm going to get sponsorship from them. What exactly happened, Michael? Can you tell us?
Well, I was walking down the garden playing with my next door neighbour, but he wasn't there. So I went to go and get my own ball to play, and then I heard this noise.
What sort of noise was it, Michael?
It was like a rutting noise.
Like a what? A rutting?
A rustling.
A rustling?
Yeah. And then I turned around. I didn't see what it was, but something went on my neck. And it bit me, and all the blood was coming down. I took it off, and then when I took it off, it bit my finger.
No. Okay, so you heard the rustling noise, then you felt the pain, then you saw the blood, and then you realised it was a squirrel attack. Okay. Could you show us the scars, please? I know they've subsided somewhat now, and perhaps they weren't looking as impressive as those panther ones, but they're still scars nonetheless. I think Grant probably is a good cameraman. He's got a steady hand. He'll probably take those in. Let's have a look. So there's, can you see that there? There's a scar just there.
And there, look, that's where it bit him.
That's where it bit him, right through the nail. That's the whole nail. Through the nail, that's the whole nail.
But you can't see the one, he did have one on his neck.
Yeah, the stitches are out now and that's all done. Okay. Yeah. Do we know where the squirrel had come from?
Well, he was in a garden for quite a while, and since he's been in there, he's attacked our cat, Oki.
He's attacked the cat, Oki?
Oh, no!
And he's got the better of his exchanges with the cat as well. You think he can overmatch the cat if it came to a battle in, say, a skip? Okay. Has the incident affected you, Michael?
Well, on the night, I had nightmares, but ever since then.
You've had nightmares, so that's
quite
heavy trauma. Don't have nightmares. You know, most squirrels, they're fairly okay. Yeah. You know, but you don't know, because they're changing. They're evolving as a species. They're becoming more vicious. Monique, why has the squirrel not been caught? If this was a dog, it would now be in a police cell probably, it'd be put down. Yeah, it'd be put down, unquestionably.
Yes.
If it was a panther, there'd now be villagers out with, I would think, pitchforks, saying, "Are you with me, lads?" And perhaps they'd even burn the Wicker Man, especially the fallen.
Well, I rang our local authority, and basically they said, they asked if it was damaging our property, and I said no. And they weren't interested.
Shocking.
Never mind that he's attacked my son.
Yeah, no, it's property. Property 9/10 of the law, isn't it? What about Michael? Is he the other 10th?
Well, they told me to hose the squirrel down. And
hose him down?
That's it. That's all I got out of them. So that basically, they just weren't interested. And I found out recently he's also attacked or bitten a builder, my next-door neighbour's builder.
Right, if that builder is watching, if you are that builder in their local, whereabouts do you live again?
Beckenham.
They live in Beckenham. If you are that builder and you've been attacked by a squirrel in Beckenham, you can call us absolutely anonymously and we'd love to hear from you, we really would. I know there's a lot of shame and probably your workmates will probably mock you on site for that. But please, give us a call. Okay, so the squirrel has attacked again. It is still lurking in your garden.
Oh, yes, it visits the garden about 6 times a day.
And you know it's the same squirrel?
Oh, yes,
because grey squirrels, a lot of them look similar.
Oh, no, it's the same one. How do you know? Well, it's the same one. He's very aggressive. He just stays there on the fence.
Is he goading you, as Les implied?
Well, when we go out in the garden, he just stays there on the fence. He makes an aggressive noise.
What's his aggressive noise, Monique? Come on.
A sort of a screeching.
Do it, Monique. Do it, Monique. No, please, Monique. Please. I've never asked a guest to do this before, but I want you to squawk like an aggressive squirrel.
We need to know.
Please. It's really important, Monique. This. It's really important. If not, I'll get Denise to do it. Please, Monique. Come on.
Do you know, Michael?
Can you do one of you, Michael or Monique? Please. We must know this sound.
Need to know.
You know that awful.
Go on. Roughly, what is it, Monique?
No, I can't.
Now sound have got involved. We've called it on. Come on. It can't sound anything like that.
It just sounded just like that.
Come on, what does he do?
Go on, Michael.
Come on, Michael.
Come on, Mikey.
Come on, Mikey.
Come on, Mikey.
Screech.
Screech, come on, Monique.
What?
What are you, woman or squirrel?
Woman, I hope.
Oh, you see, I'm sorry about this, viewers. Just, no, I've been timed out by sound there. They won't wait around, because I think that particular drum roll, Graham, lasts for 36 seconds. And then they have to start looping.
Sorry, I can't.
They have to press another button. It's hard work in there. Do you know, we've got Danny Nynum on the line. He's a wild animal expert, ladies and gentlemen. He's currently hunting the big cats in Trelech. He was on the show a while ago, updating us about the situation in Trelech. South Wales. Hello, Danny.
Hello, John.
How are you this morning, Danny?
Very.
Hello there. Is he gone?
Hello.
Hello there. Have you ever encountered a squirrel like this, Dan?
No, not in Great Britain. We had a case a couple of years ago in America, but not in Great Britain.
What was the fate of that squirrel in America? I presume in a nation where they have the right to bear arms, it was a pretty rapid death for that. It's probably a pretty rapid death for that little sucker, I would think.
Yeah, they shot it dead.
Yes, yeah. Doesn't surprise me. Does not surprise me. In a nation, you can buy a shotgun in a supermarket. It seems to be a very easy solution there in terms of pest extermination. A squirrel's known for their aggressive behaviour. I read accounts from time to time documenting this sort of incident.
From time to time, we do get this, as with the most animals, John. You'll get a rogue with big cats, an elephant, etc. It does happen from time to time.
But this rogue squirrel, you're saying it's just a bad apple, or is there a bad bunch knocking around?
No, basically, it's just a bad apple. Just a bad apple.
It's just a bad apple. Can you be sure of that? I mean, it's just that I read about a gang of squirrels on an estate in South London that are terrorising locals, even hiding under pensioners' beds, which is a true report in the newspaper. It's a true report in one newspaper. So do you think squirrels are fighting back? Are they evolving in some way?
There's a strong possibility of that, John. I think so in this case.
Sorry, I didn't catch that, Dan.
There's a strong possibility of that in London, but obviously I don't think so in this case.
Okay. But what about what they did to red squirrels? I mean, we know they're a racist animal. I mean, they have aggression in them, and they are, you know, undoubtedly, by what they did to the red squirrels, they are an aggressive, expansionist breed. Might they see humans as their next quarry?
In some cases, as I said, definitely. They are an aggressive animal to an extent because they've almost eradicated the red squirrel in most of Great Britain. We've only got a few small pockets of red squirrels that you can see in this country.
Okay, thank you very much. What would you recommend they do when next confronted by the squirrel? Obviously, in this country, we haven't got the freedom to take the US route. What would they do? What should Michael and Monique do?
Well, there's two things you can do with an animal, a rogue animal like this. You can trap the animal successfully and then leave somewhere else where it's not going to harm humans. Or you can take the American route and shoot the animal.
Okay, that's enough, Dan. Thank you very much. Thank you, Michael. Sorry, thank you very much, Dan. Thank you very much indeed, Dan. So, do you know any local trappers?
Well, can I just say, my neighbour has a trap.
Is he a trapper?
Well, he has trapped squirrels in the past, every year, in fact, in his loft. And he had the trap out for a week, and the squirrel just didn't go in it. So, I mean, he's obviously too clever.
Wily. Who's next? Michael and Monique. Michael and Monique, thank you very much for coming down and telling us your rather grim tale. Signing that for you.
Thank you.
I would recommend, though, if you are in trouble with squirrels, obviously call your local trapper. Do you know what? We're going to take a break now. Donna is in the phone room. This is an artist's impression of what we believe this squirrel to look like. Yeah. There we go. The eyes, obviously, we've done for dramatic effect. Look at his eyes. Look at his eyes.
Look at the eyes.
Denise was having that photograph for the rest of the show. She'll have that for any callers that call in. Please, any instance of squirrel aggression, give us a call on the usual number. We're going to take a break now, back in a couple of seconds. This is The Big Breakfast on the glorious Channel 4. Do not go away. Michael and Monique. Yeah.
Still to come on this morning's show, we get all animated with the real-life capers of Adam and Joe.
Every time I look at you, I feel like I'm floating.
You are floating. Freeling's turned the gravity off again.
Sorry! Spoosen, I don't know how to say this, but I think I've broken my collarbone. But I also think I love you.
2nd of September. Adam and Joe are going to be live in the house.
Yes, as part of Animation Week on the glorious Channel 4, we've also got Tom York from Radiohead doing
an exclusive
interview. An exclusive one with Jasmine Lowson, and we've got our Plum of the Week, ladies and gentlemen.
You plum.
But right now, who are we going over to? We're going to Jasmine Lowson for the Big Breakfast News and Weather. Here's Jasmine.
Good morning. These are the main stories on Friday, the 22nd of September. Brown gets a bit shirty, Bad Friday in Northern Ireland, and Bono rocks Capitol Hill. The Tories are calling for Gordon Brown to resign over the Bernie Eccleston donation, despite the Chancellor's insistence he didn't mislead the public. A new book claims Mr. Brown did know about the £1 million gift, but speaking about the allegation for the first time in a Channel 4 interview, he said he hadn't lied at all.
I've never met Eccleston. I've never talked to him about donations. I've never talked to anybody about corporate donations to the Labour Party.
Northern Ireland's First Minister David Trimble has suffered a major blow. The Ulster Unionists have lost the Antrim South by-election. The seat was won by the Democratic Unionists. Their leader, the Reverend Ian Paisley, is claiming the victory as a clear signal against the Good Friday Agreement. U2 frontman Bono has been making a noise on world debt in Washington. He joined lawmakers and cabinet members on Capitol Hill, asking them to pay more than $400 million to relieve the debt of the world's poorest nations.
Is it just going to be the good time, boom time for America? Or is there an idea that perhaps could change the world a little bit?
The Concorde, stranded in New York, has landed back at base in Paris on what could be the last flight for the supersonic jets. Aviation authorities withdrew Concorde's airworthiness certificate following the Paris crash, which claimed 113 lives. No passengers were allowed aboard the flight. Here's the sport. The only person that can stop the British Olympic team scoring a duck in the pool swims today. Mark Foster contests the 50-metre freestyle in Sydney this morning. If he fails to make the podium, it will be the first time in 64 years that the British swimming team have come home empty-handed. A spectacular crash cheated Britain out of another Olympic cycling medal yesterday. In the Madison team event, everything was looking a nice shade of bronze with only one lap to go when Rob Hales ploughed into a felled rider. The accident cost dear, allowing the Italian team to overtake and finish in third place. Here's the way the weather looks. Temperatures should range from 16 Celsius in Glasgow to 19 in Plymouth. Northern Ireland and East Anglia will escape the rain this morning, but the dry weather will move to the Midlands and the southwest later today. Here's the five-day forecast. More rain tomorrow in Scotland and Northern Ireland, but there'll be sunny spells until Wednesday. In northern and central regions, dry, warm weather throughout the weekend, and in the south, after a sunny spring-like weekend, the rain will be back by Tuesday. Breakfast News, it's 7:35. Now it's back to Johnny and Denise.
Thank you very much indeed, Jasmine Lowson. Do you know we have a scripted conversation with you now?
Sorry, Johnny.
We've got a scripted conversation here now because it is time for your interview with none other than Radiohead's Tom York. Were you nervous?
Yes, I was. Sorry, I've got someone talking in my ear.
It's me.
Yes, I was a bit nervous, but he was a very nice chap. He's heavily involved in this Jubilee 2000 campaign, which is to cancel debt owed by the world's poorest countries, and he's very vocal about that. But everyone knows he's got this new album out, and I thought the main focus of the interview was going to be on that, but he wasn't having any of it.
Oh dear.
He did not want to talk to me.
So you thought that someone was going there to plug an album and were disgusted when actually he plugged a worthy cause?
Yeah, I mean, you've got to respect him for plugging his calls and not, you know, his album. But he was totally impervious to my charms. He didn't want to go there.
OK, thank you very much indeed. How do you think, how do you think you'd gone on? It's your first interview for us.
Sort of Jeremy Paxman-like.
Paxman-like, OK. Yay! Well, we're with the judge of that now as we see Jasmine Lowson's encounter with Radiohead's Tom York. Anything you'd like to plug?
Not at the moment, no.
OK. think about that. OK, let's have a look at this. Here we go.
Plug anything?
Plug anything you like.
This is what you get when you mess with me.
Tom York, thank you for joining me. You've come here to talk about Jubilee 2000 and your involvement with it. Firstly, what is Jubilee 2000?
It's about cancelling the unpayable debts owed by the world's poorest countries.
So what spurred your interest in it?
I saw an editorial that Bono wrote in The Guardian, so I sent him a letter saying I want to help out, really, because I thought it was a great idea.
So how are you going to help?
I'm doing this. I'm doing PR day.
No gigs planned? You're not going to meet the Pope or anything like that?
Well, no, I think gigs were ruled out initially. I'm not sure what I'd say to the Pope, and I don't think he'd want to meet me anyway.
Okay.
I'll quite happily hurl abuse at politicians. I could do that for a living.
Now, we've spoken about GB 2000, but you are a musician, first and foremost, yeah. And a busy one at that. How do you fit in your work with Radiohead?
Well, it's been kind of all right. All the stuff I've done since has been fine because we were working on very little. So when I went to the Clone Summit, it was fine. This year, it's a bit more stressful, but it's okay. You know, it doesn't take long to do bits and pieces. No, cool.
At the moment you can't move without hearing about Radiohead. Are you comfortable with that sort of high profile?
No, I'd much rather talk about this really in terms of, you know what I mean, talk about anything. It's much more useful.
Tom York, good luck with all your work with the campaign and Thanks. Thank you for talking to us.
Thanks a lot.
Oh, it'd be nice to have known a little bit more about the album, though.
It would be,
yeah,
wouldn't it?
But still.
Still, there we go. Do you know what? You've got throws in your house, haven't you?
I have, yes.
Have you just bought
lots
a new
of them.
You bought a new throw?
Yes, from the pound shop.
Oh, nice. Was it nice?
Yeah, it's lilac.
I bet it was.
Why are you asking me that?
Because we're about to throw to Donna.
Ah!
He's there with a Versace
That's flea. So rich of me.
A Versace hat. Here we go.
What are you up to, Donna?
Thank you. Yes, we're going to go from one interview straight back into another one here at The Big Breakfast because since the release of debut single Flowers, this band has been travelling up and down the country on a huge UK club tour as well as putting the final touches to their debut album. They're here all morning. It is Sweet Female Attitude! Yay! Good morning. How are you, Donna?
Very well, thank you.
I'm very well. It's lovely to see you again.
You too, yeah.
It's always good fun, I can assure you. So we're going to have a little look at your new video in just a moment.
Oh,
but
yes.
First, tell us all at home a little bit about it.
It's German directed. We actually chose a different treatment, and I'm not afraid to say.
Yeah.
It's about 7 days in a week. The couple don't have time to see each other because one works a different shift and one works another shift.
Yeah. Just tell us about it. We can really relate to that, don't
you?
Yeah. Can't we?
I bet
it's
you
just
can.
Not enough hours in the
Woo!
Day.
I know. So we, as angels, even though we're not transparent, invent an eighth day where we spend it together.
8 days a week. Let's have a look at it.
That's on Monday, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
And this is your first single since the massive, huge success of Flowers. So were you worried at all that you would become a one-hit wonder?
Yes.
Yeah.
Because not everyone always
Straight to the
that,
point. That's what I love about you guys.
Oh, lovely. We was worried about that because everyone has said, you know, well, you got one hit, will you have another? But we're not actually sure how well the second single will do that we've just seen. Mm-hmm. But the third one is the one.
Is it really?
Yeah,
it
and
is.
Plus with the second single, I mean...
You're meant to be selling this one, girl.
I know.
Let's push it a bit more.
I think with the second single, what it was as well, of course, you know, bands bring the second single out like 2 or 3 months mm-hmm. later, whereas ours was like a band of 6 months. So people were saying, you know, where are you, where are
what
you?
What have you,
know,
you been doing? Where have you been?
Done the album.
Yeah.
Finished album.
Oh.
We've now
been Danish.
Yeah,
do you speak Danish?
No, that's German.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe you could come and deal with my neighbour. I'm having terrible problems, but that's another story. So,
no, not Natalie.
The German.
Oh, I'm not going to go there, please. Anyway, back to the interview. The band's been described as a dance act pop act, and you've also been called Manchester's homegrown divas. How
that's
would
lovely.
You define yourselves?
Lazy and don't like to get up at 4 in the morning to do the show.
I'm only
like
joking.
Like our third caller and foster mine, but there you go.
So you've worked with the same successful team that produced acts such as The Great Westlife, The Glorious
Five,
and that classic Another Level. How much control do you have?
Well, we write a lot of our own stuff, so when it comes to doing the album, it was like, mm-hmm. you know, sing this song, and at one stage we were like, you know, we'll try and get our own songs on.
Do they try and do that, though? The record company
Definitely.
Push stuff on you, can, like, make you this in this country, make you that, and you lose what the sense is, what you started doing it
Definitely.
For, what you're all about.
Yeah,
there is always that in the cafe.
Yeah, and I think...
With the second, I mean, the first album now, we've got songs on it and people are saying, you know, the record company says to us, maybe we're not putting your songs on, but we're trying to get hit songs, you know. Yeah. We're trying to get 15 songs that are all hits. So, I mean, we went along with it, but we do have a bit of a say.
You're skint.
She spends it all.
Really, do you? What do you like to spend your money on?
Clothes, watches and beds.
So what do you make of this full pop star lifestyle? Because you've been thrown into this world of show business and parties and pop stars. What do you make of it all?
No, we don't go. We never get invited to parties.
Really? But you're such good party girls. You can come to my party. Denise is having a party.
I believe so. Yeah, excellent. No, because we're such homebody girls. We're like, go back to Manchester.
Do you still live there?
Yeah, we do. Mm-hmm. I still live with our parents because we're skint.
Oh. Really?
There's nothing wrong with my mum and dad, like,
so you don't hang out and live this showbiz pop circle.
I mean, it's
do you
great,
have any friends who are pop stars? And
you now?
Yeah,
you are.
My singing career is over. but there you go.
You are? The Lord.
Thank the Lord. We're going to have an old Christmas special.
There is a God.
Oh, dear. And tell us about your album very quickly, because it is coming out soon.
Yeah, no,
it's going to
be out,
definitely.
It's going to be out in January. Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's not only garbage, it's about four garbage. R&B, there's some pop music,
With Flowers.
Mm-hmm.
With Flowers, I mean, it was a case of, you know, 3-year-olds loving it and then adults loving it, so we didn't want to lose anyone on the album, so bit of R&B, bit of garage, bit of pop, bit of everything for everybody.
Indeed. All right, and before you go, I know Manchester, who you're fans of, are playing Chelsea tomorrow, is that right?
I'm not a football fan.
Oh, really? Are you? So come on, what's you and Johnny want to have a little bit of a sweepstake on this? What do we think? Can we get a bit
you
of
give
a,
me the draw?
Because it's going to be a big audience.
Chelsea not doing too well, you give me the draw?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Would you say tenors then,
Okay.
All right.
Thank you very much to Sweet Female Attitude. Thank you very much, girls. We'll be playing and we'll be having a sweepstake on the football. But right now, this is Channel 4. You're watching The Big Breakfast. Give it up for the girls.
Like you, I wouldn't dream of watching Channel 4 normally, obviously, but they've given me my own show. It's a stepping stone, really, to a proper channel. It's called Meet Ricky Gervais, and it's on Fridays at 11. If there are any half-decent channels watching, give me a call, please, anyone. Not BBC Two.
If you could just look after the shop for the 3 weeks I'm in here, I've got some lung thing from the smoke from the fire.
From the 56 a day, Mrs. A, and you know it.
Rubbish!
And these are the lungs of a healthy non-smoker.
Ooh, yuck. It can't be that bad having lungs like that. Mrs. A's still alive?
Only just.
Hello there. Ever made a fool of yourself?
Yeah.
Of course you have. We all have. Back off, Matt. Back off.
That's a good shot.
Thanks. We all have, but we're now going to celebrate those people who've managed to turn bungling into an art form. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, it's time once again to salute those disasters waiting to happen in...
Plum of the Week!
Our reigning champion is Tony Johnson, whose streak at a football match cost his beloved Blackpool the game. You plum. This week we'll be scrutinising three more contenders and our panel will decide which one deserves the Plum of the Week crown. So without further ado, let's meet plum nominee number one, Andrew Larpent from Bristol. Morning, Andrew.
Morning.
How are you this morning?
I'm fine, thanks. Fine.
You plum.
Thank you.
Why should you be elected as our Plum of the Week? What happened?
A bit more of a prune of the week, to be honest. But
That's good.
I work for a charity in Bristol called Click.
It wouldn't be Click.
It would indeed.
Just a wild guess.
Cancer and leukemia in childhood. And on Tuesday morning, I was on my way with a colleague to a major presentation to a big corporate we were hoping to bring on board to support the charity.
Yeah.
Just coming up to the junction of the M4 out of Bristol, two motorbikes come past me very fast on the outside, and one wants to go left, one wants to go right.
Mind your elbows, going very
plow near into each other. Sorry, Denise.
Yeah, be careful.
And a very nasty crash. One of the cyclists gets catapulted over the crash barrier, clearly badly hurt. The other guy is dazed and wandering around. The two bikes in the middle of the carriageway. So we get out of the car, I stop with a colleague. We go and try and
rescue one of us the guy goes, who's gone over the barrier.
He's clearly injured. The two bikes are in the middle of the road. We move the bikes out of the way. And then we look around, and where's the other guy who wasn't injured?
Yeah.
He's decided he's got a more pressing engagement than mine, so he's taken my car and driven off.
He's nicked your car!
What were you thinking? You numb.
He stole your car.
He stole my car with all my kit in it and...
Everything for your presentation and your laptop and your phone.
You said you had all your kit in it. What sort of kit?
My kit.
Careful how you're saying kit around the silver
lane. All the things you need to make life
more exciting.
You know,
you're my on my way.
Easy when you're talking to the silvery vixen.
Two bags of dog food in the back.
Now we're talking.
Okay, listen, thank you very much for telling us your story, Andrew. You're quite a plum there. The crew will decide in a second. Let's have plum number two, ladies and gentlemen, Nikki Flash from Toppers and Devon. Flash! Right, welcome to the show. What makes you a plum?
Well, most people go to talent shows to try and further...
Go to what?
Talent shows.
Talent shows, okay.
To try and further their career, but I just go and burn the theatre down.
Okay, is that what you do?
Yeah.
What are you boasting you're like an arsonist and it's a sick thing, or...?
Well, actually, I'm a comedian entertainer, but I do a bit of magic.
So what did you do, Nikki Flash?
Well, I was South Africa...
So Flash, not real name there?
No.
Flash.
Yeah. I was in the grand final of a talent show in Eastbourne, and everything was going well. I was on the stage, I had a lady on the stage doing the magic. I looked round, and there was smoke appearing from one of the lights on the actual side of the stage, and what happened, the curtain had landed on the light and decided to catch fire.
Right.
So we got smoke and we got a little hoe appearing, and then it got better.
A little hoe?
Yeah, little flames and everything.
All right.
Next minute, there's a lot more smoke, and the audience, I'm trying to put it out.
Yeah.
And the audience are thinking, oh, this is
part of the show.
Yeah, right. They think it's absolutely fantastic.
It's Nicky Flash, he sets fires to theatres. It's a great act.
I mean, it's Tommy Cooper. You remember when he died on stage?
Yeah, yeah.
No one believed me. Well, I was trying to explain to all the technicians everything that.
And they just think, this is a great performance. This guy really believes the theatre's on fire.
And they just thought, this is fantastic, you know, how he gets the smoke and everything. So I gave the microphone to the girl, I said, tell him a joke, and I went off and put the fire out.
You plumb. It's just not too plummish, is it? That's not that plummish. It's not that, because it wasn't your fault it caught fire.
Well, it was partly, yeah, because I asked for the curtain to go back that way, so...
Okay. Well, off you go. I'm going to hear our next one. That's Nikki Flash.
Never put your curtains near a naked flame.
Never put your curtains near a naked flame. Do you know, Denise, it's so nice that you can fish out meaning from these things. Yeah. Thank you very much for that.
Who's next? Nice.
Lloyd is next. Come on in, Lloyd, ladies and gentlemen.
Actually,
it's got Paul Lloyd.
Yeah, I'm just known as Lloyd.
Lloyd.
He's known by his surname. Okay. So welcome to the show, Paul. Why should you be voted Plum of the Week?
Well, my little boy and I saved up and we were going to buy his mum a car for her birthday next month.
Oh, lovely.
And we went and paid the money, picked up the keys. While we picked up the keys, we went and bought out half of Halfords, doing
just stuff, accessories, air freshness.
100 quid we spent on that.
Sheets.
Everything, the whole lot, the works. And when we got back to where the car was parked, it wasn't there anymore. The council towed it away and crushed it.
The council towed it away and crushed it.
But what makes me the bigger plum is that while we were picking up the keys to the car that was crushed, I lost my friend's car keys and his house keys. He had to break into his house and break into his car. It's cost me over 700 quid in total.
You plum! You plum!
That's
one of the most plummish of plummy things I've ever known. Please stand by the chair and let's wait for the crew to make their... We'll do this by volume. Will you vote now for plum nominee number one? This is Andrew Larpent, who stopped... I'm going to stand up for this today. It's a big moment here.
Okay.
Will you vote for plum nominee number one? Andrew Larpent. Who stopped to help victims of a bike crash, only to have them disappear up the M4 in his own car. Or will you vote for plum nominee number two, Nikki Flash, who almost saw his act go up in flames, or plum nominee Paul Lloyd? OK. Votes for Andrew, please.
Plum.
OK, Nikki Flash, number two.
Plum.
Is that more than one?
Plum.
It's a silly way of voting, isn't it?
And last but not least.
Plum number three, Lloyd.
Yes!
Yes! Ladies and gentlemen, please, on the throne, Caprice do the honours. It's a marvellous, let's move over, Denise. It's a marvellous.
You plum!
As one, we cry.
You plum!
And just to top it all off, Sweet Female Attitude wanted to give you a little gift as well. They're bringing you flowers in the pouring rain.
They're bringing you flowers.
Oh. Don't. I am in a whirl of girl.
Okay, it's back on.
Tuck them then.
Do you know what? I've got to run. I've got to see you later.
Where are you going, Johnny?
My hair!
Where is he going? Go on, Matt.
It's going very well indeed, Johnny. We're taking all kinds of calls. We've had a lot of faxes coming in.
What about the ones with squirrels?
Yes. We've had one that's been... We've had an anonymous caller here. He's been attacked by a squirrel at Centre Parks.
Right.
We've had another
at
sighting of five squirrels living in a loft. They venture into the house and eat lots of chocolate when the lady goes
it's
out.
It's a gang. That's a gang.
A gang of squirrels there. We've had another one from Jen in Helmsborough. Squirrels have no respect for people's privacy and one's moved into their loft again. We see a lot of squirrels in lofts.
In lofts. They like that
only
in the winter.
Only scaring two young children. Oh. And breaking the vent in the loft as well, so it's vandalism too.
Okay, thank you very much indeed, Donna.
And we put those all over the board then.
So keep those calls coming in, please, a bit about these malicious grey squirrels. There's a... Our art department have done that to show you exactly the kind of vermin.
Yes, can I just say as well, Johnny, we particularly would like to hear from the builder that was recently attacked by the same savage beast that young Michael Rayner was as well.
OK, thank you very much indeed. We're still anxious for that.
Yeah, the builder.
So, no real developments there, Donna, thank you. Sorry, no, a lot of developments there. I got that wrong way round. I'm used to saying no real developments. Do you know, we're going to take a break now, back in a couple of seconds. This is Donna Eyre. She's womanning the phones all morning. Back in a couple
and
of
I'm
seconds.
Nuts yeah. about it.
I'm Paul Tonkinson, and with me, I've got six students, all hoping to pay off their loans with one throw of this mistress of fate that is the dice. With a little bit of luck, fast fingers, and a generous helping of trivia, one of these poor students will pay off their entire year's debt. Which farm animal has an orgasm that can last up to half an hour? You've won William G. Stewart's tie. Yes, it's Dyson with debt.
Wednesday at 6 on 4.
Welcome to the Big Breakfast. It's Friday, the 22nd of September. I'm Johnny Vaughan.
And I'm Denise Vaughan.
Okay, settle down. Have you noticed how rude those German teddy bears are? They're all fat, aren't they? You can hardly move on a beach for those big bears, can you?
Big, woohoo, and bear. Well, here's two for the price of one, isn't it, Johnny?
I can hardly understand what you're saying, Denise, but I like it anyway. What about the French, though? What about the French? What about the dome, OK? And what about those barmy boffins, though?
Ooh, I like a bit of boffin!
What do you think you're doing?
Oh,
you're
we're
taking
just,
the mickey out of us.
Improving on your show.
No, come on, this side, outside.
Easy, fellas.
Trying to jazz it up, I think this looks good.
I just nipped to the loo.
Do you know what? You invite people on the show, and this is how they repay you, Denise.
Yeah.
You've got them to give an honest to goodness plug on the Big Breakfast.
That was quite flattering. That wasn't our rude impression.
I know it wasn't. You know, I saw the stuff we censored out. It's shocking, lads.
I made you sound manly.
Well, thank you very much. Thanks, mate.
And me.
Yeah, and me too. What are you talking about?
Adam and Joe are in the house.
Adam and Joe.
Do
you know what, Adam and Joe? They're not the only people on today's show. No, they certainly aren't. After the news, I'll be having a good old rummage through the dailies to bring you the nation's favourite paper review, ladies and gentlemen. Yes.
And then at 8:20, we meet the leaders of the animated world, Adam and Joe.
Adam and Joe, ladies and gentlemen. At 8:30, Kirsty Drewer is here for a spot of browsing in our internet feature, Windows Shopping.
Plus, there's cartoon capers in a special edition of our competition. Ooh, what a lovely pair.
And we're doing that actually in honour of Adam and Joe this morning.
Yeah, fantastic.
It's an animation version of it, and you'll be taking part in helping callers.
Thank you very much.
Excellent. What?
So that's great.
Enthusiastic.
But right now, it's over. We can go over to Jasmine Lowson. She's our news lady, and here she is with the Big Breakfast.
Ooh, what a lovely pair.
Good morning, these are the main stories on Friday the 22nd of September. Camelot burst Branson's balloon, VIPs told to take cover after MI6 attack, and getting down at the Olympics. Camelot gets to take its case to keep its licence to the Lottery Commission later. The High Court reversed the decision to only negotiate with Richard Branson's People's Lottery. Branson reckons Camelot has no chance.
You know, the Commission have ruled that we had the best bid, and therefore, to be quite honest, I can't quite see, you know, what Camelot feel that they have to gain by dragging the process out.
Parts of a rocket launcher have been found near the MI6 building. Terrorists fired a small missile into the building, but no one has yet claimed responsibility. Security forces are on full alert and political figures are being warned they must consider themselves targets. It's thought the real IRA may target the Labour conference in Brighton next week. ITN is set to do it again, but this time only 3 to 4 nights a week. ITV has agreed to bring back the much-loved News at 10 time slot, but has reserved Friday nights and some Thursdays for movies. The earlier time starts in the new year. 800 towns and cities across Europe were closing their central streets to traffic today for European Car-Free Day. 10 local areas in Britain are set to follow in the footsteps of countries such as France and Italy, but with the recent fuel crisis, many may not notice much of a difference. Camden and Covent Garden will shut off several roads, while a street party is to be held in Brixton. Record crowds of up to 400,000 headed to Sydney's Olympic Park today as transport officials tried a novel way to keep commuters calm. A jazz band kept the packed halls humming a happy tune as they waited for trains. Today's being described as Super Friday, as it's the first time all venues are open for competition. Here's the sport. There were mixed fortunes on the first day of athletics at the Olympics today. 400 metres medal hopeful Jamie Bulsh failed to make the grade. On a brighter note, the trio of Dwayne Chambers, Darren Campbell and Jason Gardner all qualified easily for the next round of the 100 metres. Steve Backley and Mick Hill both threw themselves into the javelin final. French runner Marie-José Parec has dramatically walked out of the Olympic Games just a day before she was to defend her 400-metre title. The athlete complained of being attacked in her Sydney hotel room yesterday. Parec and her boyfriend then flew to Singapore, where they were both involved in a fracas with a cameraman. Here's the way the weather looks. Temperatures should range from 16 Celsius in Glasgow to 19 in Plymouth. Northern Ireland and East Anglia will escape the rain this morning, but the dry weather will move to the Midlands and southwest later today. Here's the five-day forecast. More rain tomorrow in Scotland and Northern Ireland, but there'll be sunny spells until Wednesday. In northern and central regions, dry, warm weather throughout the weekend. And in the south, after a sunny spring-like weekend, the rain will be back by Tuesday. Breakfast News, it's 8:04, and I'm back to Johnny and Denise.
Thank you very much indeed. Ladies and gentlemen, Jasmine Lowson. There's some headlines. They're ready to be read out to you. Let's hear the cry, please, ladies and gentlemen, so we can start. Daily Express, first of all, one of the mid-sheets. Dome Minister lied to Lords. An accountant's audit suggests that the Dome was insolvent during a period in which Lord Falkland told the Lords it was solvent and would never be insolvent. And apparently that is a lie.
Lie.
I don't know. When they put lied in like a quote, does that mean they're only saying he lied? They're alleged, or does that mean it's definitely, it's right to say he lied?
He lied.
Let's go over to the Sun. This is a VIP bomb alert. Security forces fear the missile attack on MI6 headquarters was an IRA rehearsal. It's odd, that idea of a rehearsal, isn't it? So sort of ready to go in five.
Yeah.
I get some idea of them rehearsing. Anyway, I probably shouldn't make any comment at all. But for an attack on, they're rehearsing for an attack on senior politicians.
Really?
What exactly constitutes a ceasefire then? I don't know. Let's go to the start. Okay, you can joke about Zivar Basel. New research suggests it is possible for Germans to laugh at themselves.
No way.
I got it. I've been on a few holidays to Mallorca, and I would certainly beg to differ with that. Anyway, do you know what? I'm going to get in there, ladies and gentlemen. First up this morning, Donna has been in her phone room this morning. It's now not called Donna's slot anymore. It's now called Donna's comfy area.
Due
to the innuendo.
Donna's comfort zone.
It's Donna's comfort zone. I don't know what it is. Anything you say, Dan, just sounds sexy. Anyway, I've got some squirrel news. Donna, you're going to love this because you've made squirrels something of your special subject
this morning.
A squirrel sparked a... You're just nuts. Exactly right, Donna.
But not as nuts as you.
Well, yeah. More. Like big V.
blink the sock, you link, link, hunt,
link. Anyway, a squirrel sparked a 999 emergency when he scaled a 100-foot-high building and suddenly got vertigo. A squirrel with vertigo. Worried office workers in Aldermaston, Berkshire, called in the fire brigade after they spotted him clinging to the wall from just his, with just his back legs. And he was shivering with fear.
Oh, bless him.
Just a little squirrel shivering with fear. It might have been cold, having said that. I think they're projecting. They're projecting into the squirrel's psyche there. He hung with his nose facing down for 4 hours.
4 hours.
So I would think that shivering is also probably muscular tension as well.
Yeah,
you know, when
sure.
you grip something for an amount of time, when you're in a certain position, your knees can tremble.
Yeah, that does happen.
But when fire officers raised a ladder in a bid to reach him, he just scurried off towards safety. Do you know what I mean? The low how the squirrel mocks them.
Evil.
What?
Which
is a gesture of defiance. It doesn't actually mean anything linguistically.
Okay. Let you off.
Okay, thank you very much. Inpatients barcoded. Hospital patients to be barcoded to make sure they get the right treatment, ladies and gents. The electronic coding system, just like the one used in supermarkets, will hold details of medication which can be read using a handheld computer. Thing is, if it's like the one in supermarkets, you go to the one in supermarkets and it doesn't scan certain objects.
That's right.
So what happens when a patient gets to be operated on? It goes... You got a treatment on this one, matron! New treatments! An arm robber. Oh, this is nice. It's nice when an arm robber praises pensioners. Mm. It's high praise indeed. An armed robber has praised two elderly ladies. Actually, they needn't have said elderly because their names are Frida and Maury. Which don't need anything more. You don't even need to say they're 76 and 74. Frida and her sister Maureen confronted the knife-wielding raider when he burst into their grocery store. They said they'd give him a good thumping with a metal weight rather than hand over the takings. Frida said, I told him I'd hit him and he told me he'd hit me back. Then he said, well done, ladies, and fled. I wasn't frightened. Isn't that great? Isn't that heroism? But then they boasted, yeah, we had a gunman in here 12 years ago. I fought him off as well. And that took place in Herne Bay, Kent. Now, thank the Lord, this question has been answered in the mail. I know, Denise, you haven't slept about this. Not seagull pie. Sadly not. That was the Express. But remember the question, is the famous famous Star Hotel in Moffat, Dumfries and Galloway, the narrowest hotel in Britain? Yes, it is the answer. And it has been so since 1998, when it was noted in the Guinness Book of Records. So I'm glad that's cleared up. There was another letter as well. It says, a friend of mine met Sid Owen in a hotel toilet in Barbados. Have other people met celebrities in strange places? Well, yes, they have. How about this? This is a corker. During a service halt in the RAC rally some years ago, Derek Warwick pushed past my daughter, proclaiming, I'm dying for the loo. Who? Who is Derek Warwick? Have you all heard of him? Am I one of the people who hasn't heard of Derek Warwick? Is he really famous?
Grant knows him.
Grant, you know.
He's a racing driver. Does he live in the States?
He's probably living in the States. So it was the smoothest question I ever heard Grant ask one of our big high... Who was the guest, actually?
Marina Sirtis.
Oh, it's the woman from Star Trek. I just heard Grant just going, so do you live in the States?
The States!
Do you live in the States? Of course in the States, you know, Levi's. $18.99. How much we pay for them Levi's in the States? $18. Yeah, big bucket of beer, great big lobster like that, steak over the whole plate. How much was it?
$9.
$9. $9 we was paying, $9. Are they Levi's?
No.
How much were they? Thanks. The vanity of two criminals proved their undoing at Aylesbury Crown Court after breaking into a sports club. Andrew Jones and Jason Deakin. Sounds like a nice pair of lads, doesn't it? Anyway, and Jason Deakin photographed each other with their loot, including money and cigarettes. Money and fags. After the raid.
Sounds like an Oasis album.
It does sound like an Oasis album cover. Sounds like a night out with Liam and Noel. The pictures were found when police raided their homes. I can't believe it, the robbers are actually kind of taking photographs while they're on the job. Look at this, have a look at this one. Did I show you my bank heist snaps? Have a look. This is all the lads with their masks on. No, look, that's Terry outside the bank. Have a look. This is me with one of the hostages. Can't remember, he's a really nice bloke, really good bloke. No, don't look at that one. Okay, here we go. Fisherman John Coxford hauled a bright green lobster
from the North Sea.
No.
Bright green lobster. Bright green.
That's not a lobster, that's Kermit.
That's Kermit the Frog.
I love lobster.
But it says, John 44 of Amble, Northumberland said, well, I've never seen anything like it. In 35 years fishing, it was completely green, which must be very rare. Do you know, that's the sort of thing you've got to keep away, I would think, from your Japanese businessman, because I don't know if lobsters have genitals, but I suspect the genitals of a green lobster, when crushed, it's rare and cruel enough to be a very powerful aphrodisiac indeed for your Japanese businessman. Also, Denise, this might interest you. Gran, Hannah Bembridge, nearly croaked when she found a deep-fried frog in a bag of crisps.
Oh.
Hannah, who's had two heart attacks, said, I've got a dodgy ticker, and finding that frog could have been the end of the road. Yeah, have you ever found anything odd in a packet of crisps?
I once found a finger.
A finger?
Yeah.
In a packet of crisps? A hacked off finger?
Yes.
Denise, are you lying to the viewers again?
Yeah.
Because you didn't find a finger, did you?
No.
And you've lied now.
I found
You found a toe. Okay. But apparently.
A foot.
There was another one in here. My mum's face went green. Okay, here we go. This is from You're a Genius, the ironically titled comment column in the Daily Mail again. Many people don't have a TV set, yet sometimes they see a video advertised they'd like to watch. Why don't they come up with a machine that just plays videos?
That's a good point.
Yes, they could call it a video machine. I know, I had to sort of look at that as well. Why don't they come up with a machine that just plays videos? They must be doing this column ironically.
Who's that? Who sent it in?
That's Paul Kennedy in Matlock's.
You plum.
You plum. That's it, Matlock. Is a mini roundabout. But it's genius. You're a genius. This is the last one this morning, I'm afraid. It is interesting to note the "Are you doing your bit for the environment?" ads. In one, comedian Mark Lamar tells us, "If you want a cup of tea, just boil a cup of water, and we'll save a lot of electricity." The comment here is, "What happened to electrical safety?" When boiling a kettle, you should have enough water to cover the element. Failure to do this can lead to the element burning out and the kettle overheating. And it goes on fire. My old-fashioned kettle requires 2 pints of water to cover the element. This ad should be changed accordingly. And that's from Terry Bennett. Are they going to have to reshoot the advert? Well, Lamar actually does a personal message to Terry.
This one's for you, Terry.
Do you know what? I'm going to get in with my pun with the fun with the pun.
Okay,
this is from Wednesday's Mirror. A pub is constructed out of ice.
Mm-hmm.
Pun says, only here for the
brewery.
Is it not good?
No, it's good.
It's all right.
But you could do better.
Adam, is that not good?
No, I don't think that's good.
No. Adam's
only
not
here
impressed.
Only here for the brewery. This is beer. It should be beer, but it's only for the brewery.
That's terrible.
What would you have done as a pun for the pub?
I would have done something like,
see, it's hard, isn't it?
Ice-cold beers.
In Alice?
I don't know. All right, then it is hard.
All right, then it is hard!
OK, I admit.
OK, you admit that's a good pun. Conceded.
Yeah.
From yesterday's start. Jailbreak ratings go up when a busty glamour model displays her charms. And by charms, of course, we know they mean her breasts. The pun says, peaks time fewing. Adam and Jeff, not
good.
Bad.
That's very good, because the PH sounds a bit like an F, which sounds slightly like a V. At least it's not just a random sound like brrr.
Yeah.
At least it's a word.
Yeah, it's true, though. We should have puns and analysis.
Yes.
We've been missing a trick all this time.
Absolutely, where the men?
Adam and Joe now, with the pun analysis. All be upstanding. Oh, no, we got the pun.
No,
oh, we haven't got the pun.
It's pun of the week.
Here we go. Move back, please, child.
Get out of the
Get
way!
Get out of the way, child! Go with Adam and Joe, our pun analysts! Right, it's from today's Star, okay? A fish heads a wayward golf ball onto the green. Guys hit a shot, it's gone into a water obstacle,
mm-hmm.
and it's just bounced off. And when he gets there, he sees a dead pike floating on the top of the thing, and it's actually the ball's landed on the fish and gone onto the green.
Unbelievable.
It's unbelievable, isn't it? It is unbelievable. But it must be true. It's in the star. the pun
like
here comes.
Hay.
A real
life. Star.
The pun is in the star. Let us relax for the pun of the week. Here comes Vicky. I think
Vicky, where is she?
Here she is.
All the way from the Roman road.
She brings us puns in the pouring rain.
Puns and bash.
Oh, here she is. Genuine real life pun, ladies and gentlemen.
How are you, Vicky?
Let's have a look. She looks nice today. Look, nice little outfit.
Really.
Where's that from?
Down the market.
Is it down the market?
Roman Road?
Might be.
Marvellous.
Okay,
we're
look
ready.
$1 million. A fish heads a wayward golf ball onto the green. Denise and Vicky, please reveal the pun. Shoal in one! Oh. Yay! Okay, we're going to take a break now, back in a couple of seconds. We've still got Adam and Joe talking about the Animation Weekend, the Animation Week on Channel 4. Nice to have you down here, chaps. What else have we got this morning? Competition.
Competition, prizes to give away.
Prizes to give away.
Holiday.
Friday song, thank you, Donna.
Yep, Donna's
Harry's
in the phone room with...
Three female attitudes still here.
Window shopping.
What we're trying to say is there's still a lot to come this morning on The Big Breakfast. Do
just
not go away.
Thank you very much.
Lovely cartoon pair, you and a friend could be heading off on a twin centre holiday to Rhode Island and Vermont. The setting for the new movie Me, Myself and Irene, the outrageous romantic farce starring Jim Carrey.
How dumb do I look?
Your prize includes return flights from London, two nights accommodation in Rhode Island and four nights in Vermont. Car hire, travel insurance and spending money too. One winner must be over 21 and both of you must hold valid passports and visas. You must be available to travel during March or April next year. For your chance of winning, just answer the following question. Jim Carrey hid his identity in which comic hit film? A. The Mask, B. The Mask of Zorro, or C. The Man in the Iron Mask? And call 0900-144-7744 with your answer.
Pay attention, you guys. Animation is taking over Channel
4!
Give me your money!
A showcase for the best of talent from the strangely weird to new comedy writing.
Channel 4's biggest ever season, celebrating the best in world animation, starts Saturday from 9 on 4.
Okay, how about this one, Kenny? Mm-mm. No? How about this?
Nope.
How about this? Carmen, what the hell are you doing? We're trying to find the brown noise. It's this one pitch, this certain frequency that makes people lose bowel control. What's lose bowel control? That's a scientific term for crapping your pants.
I'm just getting a bit of height there, Den. It's animation day here on The Big Breakfast. Who better to grace our sofa? What's it say? Than the man who turned the English patient.
Windy Pops.
Bit of Windy Pops. I think I covered that very well.
The Thunsters.
Legs wide, lads. Come on. Next nice
no, because
and you, Denise.
No.
Okay. Anyway, they're the man who turned the English patient into a teddy bear's picnic. Ladies and gentlemen, Adam and Joe.
Yes,
now, you've got a one-off special on the glorious Channel 4 tomorrow night, Adam and Joe's World of Animation. In the show, you reveal your number one modern TV moment. We're going to have a look at that now by straight away destroying the climax of the show. Here we go.
And our favourite bit of contemporary animation, at the moment anyway, is from King of the Hill.
Run! 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 Look at the batter, boy! Watch the ball!
Huh? What?
Hey, don't look at me! Keep your eye on the ball!
Keep my eye on the what?
Stop looking at me, boy! Watch the ball!
Can't hear you, Dad.
Oh! Wait.
There we go, Adam and Joe's number one. That was controversial, I've got down here. You put The Simpsons at number two.
I know,
controversial amongst us. But why do you rate Hank Hill over Homer?
Because ever since Richard Madeley got heavily into The Simpsons, I feel it's lost its, you know?
Oh,
it's lost
Richard.
Its. He's a lovely, lovely man, but he's also slightly
It's
tragic.
Nice to have something, you know, for yourself that you've discovered. And when Madeley and Finnegan get involved, you know that
It's very much out there.
It's been opened, you know, wide.
It's an odd thing in human nature, that, isn't it? That thing that it's not exclusive to you anymore. Yeah. I remember that particularly happening when I was at school with bands and music you liked, and then suddenly you sort of liked this band, and you'd heard them on, like, John Peel, and it was really obscure, and you'd find a T-shirt. And then suddenly that fool would like it, and then suddenly actually just the music sounded different. And this has happened to you now with the Maidley effect. Maidley's syndrome, should be called herewith. Who is your favourite Springfield resident, if you have to have one?
I'd go for Milhouse.
I'd go for Chief Wiggum all the way.
Chief Wiggum?
All the way.
That's very perverse. I'd go for the scientist.
Yes.
Freak. What's his name? Freak.
Yeah.
You know, blah, blah, blah. And he's got the knobs in his head.
Go on, Denise, you ask question two.
Do you mind if I just button?
Yeah, go on, button, go on.
So why do you think cartoons have got such a huge following?
Yes.
Is that a good question?
Yes, good question. It's not a bad
question.
It's a big question. It depends how they treat it, really.
I guess if I was an American animator, I'd say, well, it's because when you're doing things with animation, anything's possible. And it just takes you out of the strictures of real life where there's so many rules and allows you to really go crazy and have fun.
I'd agree with Adam. Yeah. I think that's a pretty
good. But as you're not American.
As you're not American. Or Welsh, as that sounded.
As we're not American.
That's
his accent.
That was Welsh.
Well, as a Welsh person, that's terrible. I think it's because of the bright colours, basically, and the fast movement.
That's all it is.
Yeah,
isn't it?
It's just the brighter the colours.
I love the colours. And exactly. Movementally.
The speeded up voices.
And the plots are simple.
Because you love cartoons,
I love cartoons. I enjoy cartoons.
Do you love any cartoon? Any old rubbish?
I find myself these days, I do comb for things like my old favourites, like the Hair Bear Bunch. Oh, Mr. Peevely, do I get a promotion? and I really enjoy it. Like Wacky Races, I'm getting back into it.
Yeah, so you can't beat the old cartoons, I think.
I just watch them all, except things like Pokemon. I don't like the cartoons that exist just as kind of sales tools. Mm. And there's very little else there.
Well, that's been quite reductive about Pokemon. There's quite a lot else there.
Okay, thank you very much for that. I'm sorry to be so reductive.
Easy.
Now, your top children's cartoon is Rhubarb and Custard, which I adore heartily
for. Rhubarb and Custard.
The Shed Shenanigans, which was my favourite bit of the show. Let's take a quick... Do you love that?
I love Rhubarb and Custard.
Well, you're going to love this. Have a look.
And at number one, in our opinion, the most enduring retro cartoon of all, Rhubarb and Custard.
What fun, grinned Rhubarb. What jolly, jolly fun, he squealed. What new wonderments have you invented in your wisdom? What new games have you given to the world? Rhubarb rumbled on as he tied a couple of bones to his athlete's feet and announced to the world he'd invented golf.
Classic. Classic. Simple, the Shed Shenanigans, Richard Brier's doing the voice. I like the one person doing all the voices, mad for it.
And of course the theme, you know.
The music is fantastic.
That's the classic cartoon theme.
Okay, you put Danger Mouse in at number four.
Yeah, why did you choose that over Danger Mouse?
It's kind of boring, but a lot of...
We'll be the judge of
decisions
that.
A lot of decisions you have to make.
Okay, we're bored now.
Okay, yeah, go on.
Because it's not as good. Frankly, okay. Not quite as good. It hasn't got the jazz score, hasn't got the little wiggly lines on Rhubarb.
Yeah, but it's the mouse.
The question is, do you think in 20 years' time, well, not the question, there's a lot of the questions in life, but one question here, number five, suggests that, do you think kids today will look back nostalgically on Pokemon and things like that in the way that we look back on, say, Bagpuss, Mr. Ben, the Clangers, Danger Mouse, Rhubarb and Custard, and things of that ilk?
I think they probably will, but who can imagine what hideous monstrosity will be like contemporary animation then? What's going to make Pokemon look charming? God knows. Who knows?
I don't think anything will make Pokemon look charming. I think it is a low quality sales tool, as you say.
That's so reductive.
I'm starting to get into the reductive argument.
Because, you know, in our day, it was the Smurfs, you know, everyone used to collect.
To the Smurfs.
That's
where I drew the line.
Well, that's of course, but many young discerning people like yourself nowadays are drawing the line at Pokemon.
Yeah, and they were a marketing tool. Collect all the little stuff. And the window stickers, people were crazy.
Point at which my father walked in and looked at the telly and went, no!
Really?
Well, the Smurfs were awful.
They were?
Yeah, they were terrible.
And they had that dubious kind of Father
awful.
Abraham. What was he meant to be?
Yeah.
Father Abraham, was that maybe alluding to the biblical character? What was it?
He was just a...
do you know what? I've got another one. This is Bob's birthday. This is Adam Adam and Joe's World of Animation, Bob's birthday clip. Have a look at this.
Yeah, we
again, it's number one.
Number one, the forerunner to Bob and Margaret,
Bob's birthday.
I'll go and change for dinner. Does his shirt go with his tie?
Bob, put something on!
What? Hey? Curtains are closed.
Just put some pants on.
Lads, who inspires you? Is it Nick Park, Rolf Harris, Tony Hart? Who
or
the
Richard Madeley.
Or Richard Madeley. But who
Madeley.
Inspires
Madeley
you?
All the way.
Who inspires your own animation? Because I know you're accomplished animators yourself.
Yeah, accomplished animators, that's
yeah,
right.
We don't really animate. We use something we like to call Wagglemation.
We're inspired by the coat hangers you get from Sketchly when you do your dry cleaning, which is what we use
to animate. Okay.
But no, seriously, we were always inspired by The Simpsons and the high-density gag levels that you've got in there, you know?
Yeah.
And lots of little gags in the background, lots of things going on the whole time. We try and
avoid
have that,
that
in our stuff. Yeah. Avoid that whenever
avoid
possible.
That at all costs.
That level of work.
Yeah, level of work. Yeah. We try to do it a lazy way with very few punchlines.
Exactly.
That's a good way to work. In your other shows, you prove yourselves more than adept at low budget bedroom animations. Any plans for a
slow down.
And I've got to get through this. I'm being
reductive.
Reductive.
Yeah.
Any plans for a full length toy movie feature?
Yes. No. What?
We've talked about it.
Told you, too quick.
See, he understood, though. Faster mind.
Yeah. We have talked about it, and you never know, weirder and more boring things have happened in the world.
Okay, thank you very much, Adam.
And on that note.
My God, that was the hard sell. ladies and gentlemen, Adam and Joe in the house! Denise, what would be your favourite ever cartoon? If you had to pick your favourite bit of animation, what would it be?
Well, see, I actually liked Danger Mouse. That's my favourite. Do you remember the Flumps?
Yeah.
The Flumps?
Yeah.
Listen, while we discuss our favourite piece of animation, you can see what a good conversation starter it is.
Yes.
To
and
start
morph.
The conversation this,
see,
this weekend.
Like
we're going to take a break back in a couple of seconds. They've been Adam and Joe, ladies and gentlemen. See them this weekend on the glorious Channel 4.
Very, very excited on the show this morning. Look,
what?
Tell them about this, what you can win after the news.
Denise, talking through it, Denise. Give them the full sales pitch then.
Artwork. There you go. You can win this after the news. We'll tell you how shortly.
It's signed by all the people who do the voices on The
Great
Simpsons.
Great collector's item.
And Matt Groening.
Mind your nose.
Sorry, as well. That's an amazing thing to have. In fact, it's so good, I'm surprised that isn't already in Ed, our leader's office.
It was.
Isn't that an amazing thing
to
win?
No, but you can win this. You can win this.
Oh,
afternoon.
Sorry, apparently he's got one already. There we go.
Yeah.
Doesn't surprise me. Isn't that a fantastic thing?
Okay.
Adam and Joe, isn't that amazing thing to have?
To very
have,
valuable.
To, own, to place in your possession?
Extraordinary.
Okay, well, we need to keep an eye on this in case somebody tries to take it during the news. Here's Jasmine Lowson, Big Breakfast News and Weather. Keep hold of it, Vaughan.
Keep hold of it.
Good morning. These are the main stories on Friday, the 22nd of September. Gordon says no to calls for go. Tony Blair gets 20 years. And Westlife go against all odds. Camelot will meet with the National Lottery today after winning the chance to bid for the next lottery licence. The High Courts overturned a ruling which prevented them from competing to retain the franchise. It said the commissioners had abused their power when they illegally refused to allow Camelot to bid. The Tories are calling for Gordon Brown to resign over the Bernie Eccleston donation, despite the Chancellor's insistence he didn't mislead the public. A new book claims Mr. Brown did know about the £1 million gift, but speaking about the allegation for the first time in a Channel 4 interview, he said he hadn't lied at all. Serbia has sentenced Tony Blair and Bill Clinton to 20 years for bombing Belgrade. Not surprisingly, Mr. Blair declined the invitation to Belgrade's district court, which ordered warrants for his arrest, along with 12 other world leaders. In case they felt they hadn't made their point, they also ordered the defendants to pay the cost of the trial. Westlife are poised to set a new record with an old one. Their reworking of Against All Odds with Mariah Carey is poised to take the top spot in Sunday's chart. This will be the band's sixth consecutive number one, which is a new British record. If singing cover versions was an Olympic sport, they'd all have gold medals. Here's the way the weather looks. Temperatures should range from 16 Celsius in Glasgow to 19 in Plymouth. Northern Ireland and East Anglia will escape the rain this morning, but the dry weather will move to the Midlands and the southwest later today. Your breakfast news, it's 8:35. Now it's back to the house.
Thank you very much, Jasmine Lowson. With cold winds and driving rain, autumn's a tricky time of year if you want to go on a shopping spree. But now, thanks to the internet, you can put your feet up and tuck into a packet of chocolate fingers. Crumbs on the floor, it's time for...
Windows Shopping.
Windows Shopping for you this morning. Here's our resident expert, it's Kirsty Drury. Yay!
How are you?
Look at your nails, they're fantastic.
Thank you.
Very, very nice. Here, do you like this? Look.
Oh, you got a bit of
I copied your style from last week.
Very nice.
Isn't that great?
Gorgeous.
Do you see that? Marvellous. Okay, so tell us, what have you been up to?
I've been on holiday this week. I've been in Ibiza.
Have you?
Yeah.
Having it large?
Yeah, a little bit.
Was it really good?
Yeah, it was excellent. It's coming to the end of the season now, so it was all the closing parties.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone's a bit frazzled, though.
I bet. Closing parties this weekend. Okay, so what have you got for us this week?
First one is Abercrombie.com, which is Abercrombie & Fitch, which is the American brand. It's sort of becoming a bit of a cult label here due
to its... I've never heard of this before.
Haven't you?
Have you? Anybody heard of it?
Yes.
Fitch.
All right.
Yeah.
So it's just me then.
Well, it's not really available much here. You see a lot of like American music videos with people wearing it and stuff, and I think
cool
it's
cool people. That's why I don't know.
No.
Expensive?
And, sort of a bit more expensive than Gap, but that sort of style to
but
it.
Fairly reasonable.
Yeah. And so they do men's and women's wear, a lot of sort of different ranges here. Mm-hmm. And you can get like something like this, and they can get a nice
so
little close
up. That's a carpenter jean.
It is.
And very
this,
popular.
This great thing they do is this online changing room. So you can choose your jeans and then you can flick through loads of different tops to see which
That's
one that you
good
want.
That's a good idea, so you can see what it looks like.
Create a little outfit like that.
Yeah.
So there we go. There's five little
That's
ones
That's great.
There.
So how much are the jeans then?
Oh, those jeans, we'll have to click back and have a look at those. We haven't got those ones, so hold
Roughly.
On.
Roughly.
I imagine they're about 60, let's have a look.
That's
about
not 60, too 70, bad.
$50.
$50.
So that's probably about £30.
Yeah, so that's for the carpenter jeans.
Yes.
So that's on, let's just recap, that's on Abba, what is
that's
it?
That's Abercrombie.com.
Abercrombie.com.
Yeah.
Right.
And I've got some things that are available on the site. This is what they sent over for us. So, I mean, it's quite in your face,
nice.
Abercrombie.
That's great for the winter.
Quite a nice fleece.
I love the colour as well. Yeah. Is that nice?
Yeah.
Cool.
I really like that.
And just one little like, girl's item, actually, which is quite cute to go with jeans or something.
Oh, no,
cute
see, I like belt. That. See, I love a bit of gingham.
And that'll probably
Very
be about,
nice.
That'll only be about £10.
Yeah. See, that's good, £10.
Yeah.
What
and
else have you got?
One more.
Lots of sweatshirts.
It's quite a sweatshirty sort of site.
Yeah. These for girls or for guys?
Those are guys, those ones.
Now, the thing or with for geezer birds.
It does take about... It does take about 2 to 3 weeks to arrive.
Right, so it's and quite a long way. You it's coming through from the States.
Yeah, and you might have to pay duties on it as well.
Oh, really?
So they've got better
that
in
That's going to put
mind.
The price up.
Yeah.
Right, let's move on to the next website then.
Our next site is called Fabricate. And this is a site that's based in
that's
San Francisco. It's quite you, actually, isn't it?
Okay, based in San Francisco.
Yeah.
Let's get straight to it.
It's
what
quite
can you
sort
get?
Of cutting edge clothing. It's got clothing, it's got records, it's got accessories. This is one of the, these are all the designers here. This is some of the range of stuff by this designer. Quite funky, crazy, clubby stuff. The thing with it,
Very
the good
nice.
Thing about it is you're not going to see anyone else wearing it in the UK. So
yeah.
It's quite sort of individual.
Okay, so great. Like if you're going out clubbing, you want to look different.
Yeah.
Okay, let's have a look then.
First,
get your shopping
I've got
bags
here.
Out.
Is this, do you know the sort of 40s tea dresses at the moment that you've seen around? That's that sort of style here, which is quite sort of cute. That's not really you though, is
no,
it?
No, that's the sort of thing my nan would wear to go to bingo.
But that's that sort of thing.
Hey y'all!
It's like
so how much is this?
Sort of thing. It's, that one's £99.
£99 for that? You can go to Clockhouse, can't you? Get something much cheaper than that. £14, you get pearls attached. You do. I've got one. I've got one. It's my dressing up outfit.
This one is nice men's top.
Yeah.
I like this. It's got this
very nice
extra little detail here. So
oh, see,
all
that's different. It's a bit like a straitjacket, isn't it? That kind of.
I think it'll ruche up on your arms.
Ruche.
If you've got it on.
Oh, we love a ruche. Great. So how much is that?
That one's $60.
£60.
£60.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah.
Still quite expensive.
And then this is their UFO skirt. It's quite a large one, this, but I quite like the detail on it. It's quite a crazy sort of. If you're into sort of techno, that sort of crazy sort of clubbing.
Or if you've got large thighs,
you've got great legs.
That's your outfit. Okay. Not bad. What else have you got? Another
Our
new sign? Let's
one
have a look.
Is littleblackdress.co.uk.
Oh, this sounds promising.
Hold on.
I'm going out tonight, see. I could order an outfit.
Well,
they deliver in a couple of hours, do you think?
Oh, 2 days.
But that I'll go and pick it up on my bike.
It's what's really good about this one. It's very modern, very luxurious, very glamorous. In the way you actually go into the store, you can actually browse by item range or mood.
All moods.
So it depends how you're feeling. Yes. These are all the moods you can have here.
So if I'm really depressed.
So you want to look sexy.
Yeah, sexy. So let's go to sexy.
And this is the range of sexy stuff that you've got. And then I thought we'd look at the slip dress.
Since
it's
definitely.
Little black dress.
Oh, that's very nice with the split up the side. Yeah. How much is
and
that you've then?
Got four different views of it here.
That's £155.
It's not cheap, this side.
No, but it would last you. You can dress it up, dress it down.
It's really beautiful,
wear
really well-made stuff.
Take it off. Look great on the bedroom floor. Let's have a look.
Okay, so these are our three items.
Let's
it's a
have
beautiful
a look. Right,
dress.
So this is the simple little black dress with the wrap over there.
Yeah, but you know it looks
quite
really
fiddly.
Gorgeous on.
Yep. Do we like that?
Yeah.
Stan likes that. Look nice on you, Stan. Try it on for us. Okay, what else have you got
a
here?
Second one, a gorgeous little skirt.
See, that's lovely. I could see myself doing the Lombardo in
that. Bit of a salsa.
So how much is that then?
That one's 150.
150.
But it's beautifully made.
Feel that material. It's marvellous.
It's gorgeous.
What else have you got?
And our final one.
Little lacy number.
Wonderful little dress here. Again, absolutely gorgeous.
That's really nice.
And they'll do you 20% discount on your first order as well.
Oh, that's so good. That's reasonable. Marvellous. Thank you very much, Kirsty. Some great things today. Can we do underwear next week?
We did it the week before you started with Lisa Rogers.
Let's do it again. No,
we
want to get some nice lingerie ready for the winter. Okay, thank you very much, Kirsty Drake. Okay, but right now, I do believe that Johnny Vaughan's with Donna Eyre in the comfort zone.
Yeah.
What about him?
Hello, thank you very much, Denise. Denise is actually looking stonkingly fit this morning.
Yeah.
Now, in honour of the Big Breakfast Animation Day, we've got a very special giveaway indeed.
And no, you can't.
Ed, and if we could get a mic to boom down to Ed here. Ed, you give me some very special information about this particular piece. What did you say?
When we did the Simpsons piece in the summer, Matt Groening actually said that piece is virtually priceless because. You every now and again at conventions, you get one or two together of the voices, but you never get, I think we've got seven or eight voices on there, plus Matt Groening.
And I appreciate the way you change your voice and just the word convention. Every now and then you get a convention. There's a convention going on there. It's a priceless piece of art. There it is, Simpsons Mania, signed by all the gang, Harry Shearer, Pam Hayden, Matt Groening, Dan Castellaneta. They're all there, ladies and gentlemen.
Very quickly.
I can't believe this has slipped by me. Or you, for that matter. How did this slip past you, Eddie? This is normally the sort of thing you steal with a lack of...
No comment.
No comment. OK. Anyway, to win this, all you've got to do is send us your cartoon drawing, remember the Big Breakfast Crew in the style of the Simpsons, and what a start, what a choice you've got. Sturdy Girl, Baby Ben, The Webmaster, Cockney Vic. It's up to you. we'll pick the best one on next week's show. You must get your cartoons in by Friday. The Big Breakfast, Lockkeepers Cottages, Old Ford. Absolutely right, gang. And you could win that priceless piece of art. Now, Donna, you've been watching Squirrels this morning. What's happening?
You know what? We've never, ever, ever had quite a response like this. This has been quite amazing this morning. All over the country, squirrels watching and everything.
It's because of their putative perniciousness.
We've got an email here from Sam in Bristol. Said, I had a squirrel in my basement that chewed through some fibre optic cables in my computer went down for 2 days. Claire in Leicester said, every day on my way to work, I pass an acorn tree and squirrel throws acorns at me.
Keep going, Donna, with these tales of horror.
I'm an animal lover driving home and stopped to help a squirrel in distress. When I picked it up, it refusing to let go. My husband had to prise it off.
It bit, though. When I picked it up, it bit.
Yes. It was just the way that...
Yeah, no, it's a difficult crossing out, admittedly.
And we've got another one here from Roger
on,
in
Donna.
Plymouth. Said, 8 years ago, I was doing some building work, which meant I stayed in a tent. One night, we got a curry, a vindaloo, actually.
Good in brackets, just to show vindaloo, in case you wondered.
And left it in the tent to have a quick pee. When we returned, five squirrels were all tucking into the curry.
They love curry, they love violence, they are British.
We were attacked by two squirrels whilst we were picnicking in Brighton Park. One of them was clamped onto his hand and would not let go. This is with Sean in Brighton. It's been phenomenal.
It's been a phenomenal response. So evil squirrels, and we'll be monitoring those all next week. We're going to take a break now, back in a couple of seconds. Why am I suddenly sounding like a DJ? I don't know. We're going to take a break now, back in a second. What are we playing?
We're playing our fantastic competition. Oh, what a lovely cartoon pair.
Yeah, here we go.
Ooh, what a lovely cartoon pair.
Okay, this house has 20 windows, count them.
Our house.
This house has 20 windows. It's an empty turn impression. In each window is a different cartoon. And altogether they make up 9 cartoon pairs. Wait a second, Denise. 9 times 2 is 18. 20 windows. What must 2 be?
Red herrings! We've got 2 red herrings there this morning. Exactly right. We've got 2 minutes to find a cartoon pairing. First person to find one wins a holiday to... Did you just burp?
Nope.
To Rhode Island and Vermont.
Wow. What do pairs make?
Prizes!
And what do make prizes?
What do pairs make?
Pairs. Because why do pairs and prizes go together to make?
That's true.
And what does a red herring do to the prize that you will get if you pick the wrong one? Catchphrase!
So we have 3 callers on the line, ready and waiting to play the game. Let's meet them. First of all, we've got Bradley from Liverpool. Good morning, Bradley. How are you?
Hi, good morning. How are you?
Good. I'm all right, thank you. Not bad.
Okay.
Bradley, have you got any plans for the weekend? You'd like to discuss with Denise Van Outen?
Anything like, yeah, just take the easy. I've got the flu at the moment.
Oh, you've got flu?
You've got flu,
yeah.
Oh.
Well, I recommend
a nice hot bath.
Painkillers and booze in the bath.
That sounds good to me.
Just kidding.
Okay, so that's Bradley in Liverpool. Let's go to line 2 now. We've got Fran from Brighton. Is that right? Hello, Fran.
That's your real name's Fran.
Hello. Hello, Fran. My real name's Jean.
No, it's Fran. It's Fran.
Fran, how are you this morning?
I'm fine, thanks for me.
Marvellous. You haven't got flu or anything, have you?
No.
Good. Okay, have you got a lovely pair?
Yes, thank you.
Marvellous.
What are they now?
Let's go to line 3. We've got Catherine from Lincolnshire. Good morning, Catherine.
Hi.
How are you this morning?
I'm fine.
You feeling up for it?
I'm up for it.
Do you think you're always up for it?
You're always up for it?
Well, she's from Lincolnshire.
It's funny, the home of the pork sausage.
That's right. A lovely pork sausage at this time
Lincolnshire
in the morning.
Pork sausages.
Shall we play the game? Let's get on with the game.
Shall we just fun
so
around?
So we're all ready to play. We've got Bradley, Fran, and Catherine.
We're ready to play. No, we're all ready to play.
Okay. Are you
okay,
ready?
Okay. Right, play.
Remember, you've got 2 minutes to play.
Okay, 2 minutes to play. Okay.
We'll ask you 2 numbers in turn. I'll open the shutters for those 2 numbers. You pick a pair, you win a holiday.
Yay!
If you fail to pick a pair.
Okay.
I'll play on.
Listen, Dad, which half are you going to do? You do that half there. I'll just do these ones at the end.
I'll do this half here.
11 and 4, anyone's game, yeah?
I'm going to do this half here.
Okay, you do that half down there, and then but we still don't know what's in the mystery door. Could be anything in there later.
Okay, so all you have to do is remember who you saw.
And where you saw them.
Because what do prizes make?
Holiday.
And what do prizes and catchphrases go together to constitute? Okay, and what are we now? Running out of time. Okay, let's get on.
Hurry up because it's raining and my hair's going to get really messed up.
What is it doing? Raining! Okay, here we go.
Thank you.
Bradley from Liverpool, please, crack away. Roll the clock,
okay,
Bradley.
Okay, roll the clock, Black Bradley.
Number 4 and number 10.
Number four,
got it. That's Coyote.
Number 10.
Gromit. Oh,
okay. Who you saw?
Okay, Fran from Brighton.
Number 13.
Unlucky 13. For some.
And unlucky number 18.
Too much bingo.
Yeah.
Butthead. And what other number?
18.
And 18.
Down there.
Okay.
Wallace. Oh. Remember who you saw?
And where you saw them.
Okay, let's crack on with Catherine from Lincolnshire.
Number 18.
Yes, she's sounding
number
keen.
18.
And number 10.
Was it number 10 though?
Oh.
Was it? We're running out of time now.
Oh.
I can't get my hand.
Please.
No, it's the time factor is crucial. I'm building up all silence.
Come on.
Oh, could it be the door's stuck? The time's running out, the door's stuck. I can't open it because there's a crisis now. What could happen?
I feel fine.
Is that it?
We built it all up just to
sorry,
get...
Sorry,
we did all of that for you. And
so
all you can say is fine.
How do you feel? Fine.
I am not worthy.
More.
And why do you like the big breakfast?
Because it's the best thing on TV.
Yes! Love the show. Thank you for my holiday.
Love the show, thank you. Is it a holiday?
Yes.
Is it?
A holiday to Rhode Island and Vermont.
Wow, I thought it was just a DVD player.
Ow, you
sorry about that. I spat a little bit of sugar puff down your breast. More of that later. We're going to take a break now. There'll be more sugar puffs flying around. Still got the Friday song, still got Sunny, I don't know.
Oh, there's just us.
Hey.
Us.
They've gone. It's over.
They've left the house.
They've left
the
house.
Catherine and Leanne from Sweet Female Aspects. Our lovely beauty, Donna Air.
A little Versace.
Sorry, I can miss. Thank you very much,
Donna. Our internet fashion expert, Kirsty Drury. Squirrel Boy, Michael Rennie, and his mum, Monique. And our plums of the week, you plum.
You plum.
What
are they? You plum.
Don't forget, coming up just in a couple of moments, we have got our Friday song. Looking forward to that.
I'm looking forward to that immensely.
Is that it?
Yeah, I think that's about it. Except to say,
you're
I'm feeling quite roguish today. I don't know what it is. I think it's that silly competition we just had. How long before we go to the news? Oh, it's now.
About 2 seconds. This will get you going.
This will get you going, Jasmine.
Closing headlines, the Home Secretary is this morning meeting his fuel supply task force to try to halt a repeat of the blockade which brought Britain to a standstill. But it comes as Safeway's raised its pump prices by 5p a litre, and there are fears others will follow over the weekend. The fate of 2 6-week-old Siamese twins will be decided by 3 High Court judges today. They must rule whether Jodie and Mary should be separated. If they allow doctors to split the two, one child will die so the other one can live. The funeral of Paula Yates will be held on Saturday in Faversham, Kent. The 41-year-old TV presenter was found dead at her London home on Sunday. It'll be all oars crossed tonight as Steve Redgrave and his Cotsworth Fours go for gold in the rowing. A win would make 5 gold medals in a row for Redgrave. Here's the way the weather looks. Temperatures should range from 16 Celsius in Glasgow to 19 in Plymouth. Northern Ireland and East Anglia will escape the rain, but the dry weather will move to the Midlands and the southwest. That's all for me. Have a great weekend.
Oh, thank you very much, Jasmine. Have a fantastic weekend. And we'll be here to nurse your hangover on Monday morning.
Absolutely.
Coming up on next week's show, we've got Charlene Spiteri from Texas. Yay. We've got R&B diva Jamelia. Jamelia.
Who else have we got?
We've got Billy Elliot star Jamie Bell.
Wow.
And from USA, the stars of cult TV series Young Americans too. Oh. All that to look forward to.
That's all that to look forward to right now,
though. You've got us.
Harry's giving his keyboard a good fingering. Here we go.
Supporters don't despair. All donations from a certain millionaire. Will his critics let him speak at the conference next week? Yes, they fit in the electrodes to his jet.
Hey, hey!
Say, way, 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 the big breakfast is the only way to die. Wait and on, it's your number one big breakfast. So get it down, you Maggie, and stick with us from 7 to March.
Second verse.
We're watching the Olympics, we're impressed at the way some athletes wear their shorts and vests.
When they play beach volleyball, they come close to bearing all.
If you win a medal, you'll look overdressed. Say, ray, 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 yeah. Having breakfast is the only way to die. Wait in line, it's your number one big breakfast. So get out and make it, and sing with us from 7 until 9. Start off a petrol scam. All you do is spread a rumor while I'm there. Now the PM's keen to pay for that same DJ to say that the greatest guy in love is Tony Blair. Singing away, 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 rise and shine. Every breakfast is the only way.